Good morning. Today's reading comes from 1 Samuel chapter 22. When I look at the Bible, it helps me to remember that the purpose of Bible study is to get to know God better. On each page of the Bible, God is revealing to us more of His character and how He works. Sometimes I have a hard time understanding stories like these that we see here in 1 Samuel 22. This chapter starts with David, God's chosen servant, running and hiding for his life. Even though God had used David to slaughter his enemies in the past, now it looked like his enemies were more powerful than he. In this chapter, we also see that all of the priests of the Lord, except for one, were slaughtered because of the paranoia and hatred of King Saul. Even their wives, children, and animals were killed by the sword. It seems hard to understand why God would allow that. Why is it that God's enemies often look like they're stronger than God's people? Why do God's enemies get their way, even though their plans and desires are evil? Why does it look like the enemies of God are prevailing at times and winning victories? Throughout history, God has allowed evil men to exercise a certain amount of power for a short amount of time. As we take in the whole picture of the Bible, we can see times that God used his enemies to further his own purposes. But we also see the end of the story and know that we can look forward to the day when all God's enemies will be destroyed forever. Read Revelation 12. David wrote Psalm 52, 57, and Psalm 142 during this time in 1 Samuel 22. So these psalms give us the perspective we need when we face our own battle with evil. These psalms are prayers David wrote while in the cave, hiding for his life. Most of us probably have not faced enemies like David did when our lives were threatened. But there may have been times in our lives when something was threatening to destroy us. Things like loss of a job or death of a dream can cause the same type of despair. As Christians, our enemy is out to destroy us, and he tries to destroy our faith, our hope, and our joy through negative circumstances. David's life shows us that we can't count on our circumstances to change. Instead, we can only count on God's sovereign power to accomplish his purposes. David also shows us that we have to trust in God's steadfast love, no matter what our feelings might be telling us. So as we read these stories, when it looks like God's enemies are winning and God's people are being defeated, we must keep looking for what God is doing before, during, and after the story. We can't have a clear understanding without the perspective of God's victory over evil in the end. And in our own lives, when it seems like the enemy is winning and the story of our life is not what we'd hope for, we can learn from David how to keep our hearts from giving up on God. I'll close by reading some encouraging verses for us to remember from Psalm 52, 57, and 142, the psalms that David wrote during this time. Psalm 142, 1-5, David says, "I cry out to the Lord. I plead for the Lord's mercy. I pour out my complaints before him and tell him all my troubles. When I am overwhelmed, you alone know the way I should turn. Then I pray to you, O Lord. I say, you are my place of refuge. You are all I really want in life." In Psalm 52, he says, "Why do you boast of evil, O mighty man? The steadfast love of God endures all the day." Psalm 52, 8 and 9 say, "I will trust in the steadfast love of God forever and ever. I will thank you forever because you have done it. I will wait for your name, for it is good." And Psalm 57, 2 and 3 says, "I cry out to God Most High, to God who fulfills his purposes for me. He will send from heaven and save me. He will put to shame him who tramples on me. God will send out his steadfast love and his faithfulness." Let's pray. Father, I want to thank you for recording the stories of your people in the Bible. We're so grateful for the promise of your word that assures us that you are more powerful than evil. You are always at work, even when we can't see or understand, and you will accomplish all your purposes. Give us a heart like David's that runs to you and continues to look for and trust in your power, unfailing love, and faithfulness. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.